ولقد بعثنا في كل أمة رسولا أن اعبدوا الله واجتنبوا الطاغوت فمنهم من هدى الله ومنهم من حقت عليه الضلالة فسيروا في الأرض فانظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين.
لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد فنحمد الله ونشكره على ما أعطانا من النعم الكثيرة. We thank Allah, we praise Him upon the blessed blessings, the many blessings that He has given us. We thank Allah that we're able to go through the stories of the prophets, and we are looking at Prophet Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام, and we have already started with two lessons regarding Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And the third lesson and the last lesson regarding Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, we continue the story whereby Shaykh Abd Rahman al-Sa'di rahimullah said, ثُمَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَتَمَّ النِّعْمَةَ عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَرَحِمَ زَوْجَتَهُ سَارَةَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed His favors upon Ibrahim, favors upon favors that He has given him before, na'am, and completed His favors. Not only did Hajara give birth to Ismail, but also his first wife, Sarah, she eventually gave birth, even though she was old and he was old. And there's a story about this actually. When angels came to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam in the form of men, and they came as guests to give him this glad tiding of that he will have a child. He will have a child, and that child is going to be Ishaq from Sarah. And Sarah, as you know, she wasn't able to give birth. And she chose Hajar, her servant, and their servant girl, to be wedded by Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, because she considered herself not able to give birth. And so she sacrificed herself in order for her servant girl to be Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam's wife. So that sacrifice, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded her for that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded her. Sarah eventually gave birth to Ishaq and to a nation, because from Ishaq came many prophets and messengers. Just like from Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam came Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from the lineage of Ismail. So Ishaq was born. And just before he was born, that bishara, that glad tidings came from those angels which were guests. Allah mentions Surah Al-Dhariyat. When they came to his house, they were not eating. And he said to them, أَلَا تَأْكُلُونَ, don't you eat? Eat. He's serving them. And Shaykh Abd Rahman al-Sa'di rahimahullah says, look, he served them with his own hands, with his own self. And he was concerned for them that they should eat. This is how we should be. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was an ummah, was righteous, was hanif, Musliman, was upright, swaying away from shirk upon tawheed, and he was upon the Muslims. Look at the example, uswa hasana, a beautiful example in Ibrahim, that he was kind to his guests. Naam, ala ta'akulun, he said, don't you eat? In Surah Hud, verse 70, فَلَمَّا رَأَى أيديهم لا تصل إليه نكرهم وأوجس منهم خيفة. So when he saw that they were not actually eating and not actually going forward to eat, نعم, he realized that actually they were not human beings, and he became afraid. And so to Hud, verse 70, where he realized that they're not actually humans, they're not humans, and he became afraid. Now, I'll just bring you the. Somebody can be with me here, just for the Zahur, please. Surah Hud, please just give me Hud 70. Why did he become afraid? Because he thought that they were actually thieves. Sheikh Abdul Hamid Sa'id Hamla says, because when he saw that they were not eating food, Naam, he said, maybe they have some evil with them. I've invited you for food and you're not eating. Maybe they are thieves. Maybe they're going to harm me. But when he saw their hands went not towards the meal, he mistrusted them and conceived the fear from them. They said, fear not, we have been sent against the people of Lot. Naam. So that was also what they have been sent for, the people of Lot, alayhi salatu wasalam. But here, Shaykh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di, rahimahullah, said, he feared that they were actually thieves. He feared that they were come to take money from him or take whatever from him. فَإِنَّ الضَّيْفِ إِذَا أَكَلَ مِنْ طَعَامٍ طَعَامِ رَبِّ الْمَنْزِلِ اطْمَأَنَّ إِلَيْهِ وَأَنِسَ بِهِ. Of course, if somebody invite him to your house and he doesn't eat, unless he's fasting, it makes you feel bad, doesn't it? It makes you feel, why is he not eating? Maybe he doesn't trust me. And also I don't trust him. So that's what transpired. Na'am, Ibn al-Qayyim mentions that in Risalat Tabukiyya. He said, this is something which is not normal. You invite him for food and he doesn't eat. فَقَالُوا لَا تَخَفْ إِنَّا أُرْسِلْنَا إِلَى قَوْمِ لُوتِ. They said, don't be afraid. We have been sent to the people of Lut. And also, they have been sent to give a bishara, to give glad tidings to Ibrahim, alayhi salatu wasalam, that we have children, that he will have children from Sarah, yani a child from Sarah. And it was said, and you can read the next verse 71 and 72, وامرأته قائمة فضحكت فبشرناها بإسحاق ومن وراء إسحاق يعقوب. And his wife was standing there and she laughed, either because the messengers did not eat, yani those who came to visit did not eat their food, or for being glad for the destruction of the people of Lot. But we gave her glad tidings of Ishaq, and after Ishaq, Yaqub. And of course, after Yaqub is who? Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam. So she gave birth to a nation, not just to a prophet. She gave birth to a nation. Allah raised her. She was patient. She said in astonishment, woe to me, shall I bear a child while I am old? While I'm an old woman? And here is my husband, an old man. Verily, this is something strange. قالت يا ويلتا أألد وأنا عجوز وهذا بعدي شيخا إن هذا لشيء عجيب. قالوا أتعجبين من أمر الله؟ أتعجبين من أمر الله؟ أتعجبين من أمر الله؟ Are you amazed and find it strange? Are you amazed with the decree of Allah? If Allah wills something, He says, كن فيكون. That you are old and He wills that you have a child, being it is. Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he was created miraculously with no father and no mother. Allah said, be, and he was. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, without a father. And that's why always in the Quran you find Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam. So the mercy of Allah and His blessings be upon you, O family of Ibrahim. Allah said, رحمة الله وبركاته عليكم آل أهل البيت إنه حميد مجيد. And here أهل البيت is referring to the family of Ibrahim, because that's the context. But the Rafida Shia, they say this refers to the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we know and we love, Ahlul Sunnah love the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But this verse does not refer to them. This verse refers to the family of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. فَلَمَّا ذَهَبَ عَنْ إِبْرَاهِيمَ الرَّوْعُ وَجَاءَتْهُ الْبُشْرَى يُجَادِلُنَا فِي قَوْمِ لُوطٍ. And when the fear had gone away from the mind of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, and the glad tidings had reached him, he began to plead with us, yani our messengers, for the people of Lot. Verily Ibrahim was without doubt forbearing, used to invoking Allah with humility. Inna Ibrahim la halimun awwahum munib. Showing you the qualities and the characteristic of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, the characteristics of Ibrahim, and he was repentant to Allah all the time, again and again. And that's what inaba means. He was munib. Munib from inaba means continuous repentance. Ya Ibrahim, a'rid an hada, innahu qad jaa amru rabbik, wa innahum atihim adabun ghayru mardud. When Ibrahim, he supplicated for his father to be forgiven, Allah said, O Ibrahim, leave this. Indeed, the commandment of your Lord has gone forth. Verily, there will come a torment for them which cannot be turned back. And also for the people of Lot, when the time came for them to be punished, no one can stop the punishment of Allah upon those people, for they have transgressed. And we come to the story of Nabiuna Lot alayhi salatu wasalam, the Prophet Lot, after we finish the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he was Halim, he was Awwab, he was Munib, he was forbearing and kind, and he was also Na'am, he was upright on Tawheed, and he called to Tawheed, and he was firm and he was strong in that which he believed in Tawheed. And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him and his wife Sarah, his first wife Sarah, with a child, Ishaq, even at an old age. فَبَشَّرَهُمَا بِإِسْحَاقِ وَأَنَّهُ يَعِيشُ وَيُولَدُ لَهُ يَعْقُوبُ وَيُدْرِكَانِهِ. Then he will have also Ya'qub, and also they will live to see Ya'qub. So it wasn't just Ishaq, Na'am, but also Ya'qub will be given to them as a grandchild, as a grandson, and he is also a prophet. وَلِهَذَا حَمِدَ اللَّهَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ عَلَى تَمَامِ نِعْمَتِهِ وَقَالَ. And this is why Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam thanked Allah, praised Allah for the completeness of his blessings upon him, and said, Alhamdulillah, alladhi wahaba li ala al-kibari Ismaila wa Ishaq, inna rabbi la sami'u du'a. Praising Allah that he has blessed him, even upon an old age, blessed him with Ismail and Ishaq. Indeed, your Lord is sami'u du'a. He listens to those who supplicate to him. Continue with Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. After that, the great Mufassir Shaykh Abdul Rahman al-Sirdi rahmullah, he said, لِيُعْلَمْ أَنَّ جَمِيعَ مَا قَصَّهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا مِنْ سِيرَةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ صلى الله عليه وسلم فَإِنَّنَا مَأْمُورُونَ بِهِ أَمْرًا خَاصًّا. That wherever we learn and read from the biography and the seerah of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, then those benefits that we derive from that, they are for us specifically. They are for us. We are commanded, not just he is commanded, but we are commanded also with that which he is commanded with. Millata abikum Ibrahim. As Allah said, that this is the path of your father Ibrahim. Surah Al-Hajj, verse 78. And that means, Millata abikum Ibrahim, ilzamuha. Hold on to it. That millah of Ibrahim, which is al-ikhlas, which is Tawheed, that he was Hanif, he was upright, not turning to others besides Allah, making your heart, Na'am, making your heart a heart that is sincere, to worship Allah alone. And likewise Allah mentions Surah Nahl, verse 123, ثُمَّ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ أَنِ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. Then thereafter Allah revealed to you that you follow the path of Ibrahim, that path which is Hanifa. that is upright, and he, Ibrahim alayhi salam, is upright. قَدْ كَانَتْ لَكُمْ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Indeed, in Ibrahim there is a beautiful example. فِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ, with Ibrahim and those with him. إِذْ قَالُوا لِقَوْمِهِمْ, until the end of the verse. So here in Mumtahina verse 4, showing you that his path is a beautiful path, a beautiful example he was to the people that in his time and those who came after his time. فَمَا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ تَوْحِيدِ وَالْأُصُولِ فما هو عليه من توحيد والأصول والعقائد والأخلاق وجميع ما قص علينا أو ما قص علينا من نبأه. So everything that Allah told us about his life, his patience, his aqidah, his belief, his manners, his tawheed, his foundations that he was upon, all of that what Allah told us about is with news from the Quran, then indeed that is na'am, that is for us to follow. فَإِنَّ اتِّبَاعَنَا إِيَّاهِ مِن دِينِنَا. So following him, na'am, our following of Ibrahim alayhi salam is from our deen. To follow him in tawheed, in ikhlas. This doesn't mean that we do not follow the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But that which he, Ibrahim alayhi salam, was upon is the same as what Rasulullah was upon, is the same what Isa was upon, in terms of the fundamentals of this deen. The call was one. Tilka ar-rusul faddalna ba'dhum ala ba'd. Yes, such are the messengers, we have raised some over others. That's true. But Allah said, la nufarriqu bayna ahadin min rusulih. We do not separate between any one of his messengers. We do not separate in terms of their call. In terms of the methodology, is one. They gave importance to ibadah, to ikhlas, to worshiping Allah alone. And so we follow him in following the sunnah. Sunnah meaning the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He called us to follow him in tawheed, in aqeed, and the fundamentals. وَلِهَادَ لَمَّا كَانَ هَذَا أَمْرًا عَامًا لِأَحْوَالِهِ كُلِّهَا اسْتَثْنَى اللَّهُ حَالَةً مِّنْ أَحْوَالِهِ فَقَالَ إِلَّا قَوْلَ إِبْرَاهِيمِ لِأَبِيهِ لَأَسْتَغْفِرَنَّ لَكَ. Except for one thing, we don't follow him. And that is when he, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, sought forgiveness for his father, Azara. His father, who was an idol worshipper, a mushrik, a polytheist. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam called him with beautiful preaching. And he called him, you can read it in the last part of Surah Maryam. In the last part of Surah Maryam, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions about this, the how Ibrahim alayhi salam spoke to his father with beautiful preaching. And I will just read it to you. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. And mention and remember in the book, in the Quran, the story of Ibrahim, in verily, or indeed, he was a man of truth, a prophet. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ يَا أَبَتِي لِمَا تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعُ وَلَا يُبْصِرُ وَلَا يُغْنِ عَنْكَ شَيْئًا. When he said to his father, oh my father, why do you worship that which hears not, sees not, and cannot avail you in anything? إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ يَا أَبَتِي. Look at this, the way, the manner that he spoke to his father, addressing him, يَا أَبَتِي, يَا أَبَتِي. And throughout the whole of this adab, of this akhlaq of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, how he conversed and discussed with his father, يَا أَبَتِي, يَا أَبَتِي. Showing you his manner, his beautiful preaching with Ibrahim, with his father, even though his father was a mushrik. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ يَا أَبَتِي لِمَا تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعُ. Look at how he's addressing him. Why do you worship that which cannot hear, that which cannot see, that which cannot give you any help? لَا يُغْنِي عَنْكَ شَيْئًا. In the least. يَا أَبَتِي إِنِّي قَدْ جَاءَنِي مِنَ الْعِلْمِ مَا لَمْ يَأْتِكَ فَاتَّبِعْنِي. Oh my father, it's come to me knowledge that which has not reached you. So follow me. أهدك صراطا سويا. And I will lead you to that path which is upright. That صراط المستقيم. Ibrahim's path, tawheed, sunnah, tawheed of that time. The sunnah of Ibrahim, يعني, is to worship Allah alone. Not to worship these idols. Not to call upon these idols. Not to rely upon other than Allah. So follow me. I will guide you to a straight path. The hidayatul bayan wal irshad. Guidance of clarification, and giving news, giving na'am, the details of that guidance. Ya abati, la ta'budi shaytan. Oh my father, don't worship shaytan. Inna shaytana kana lirrahmani asiyya. Indeed, shaytan has been a rebel against the most gracious Allah. Inna shaytan kana lirrahman, to ar-rahman, he is asiyya, disobedient. He turned away. He rejected the command of Allah to bow down to Adam. And he is there given an appointed time to follow you and me, to lead us astray. So don't worship shaytan. Don't follow shaytan. Don't follow the footsteps of shaytan. He's a clear enemy. Don't take him as a guide. Don't take him as a wali. Don't take him as an aide, a friend or companion. He will lead you astray. Ya abati inni akhafu an yamassaka adabu min ar-rahman. Oh my father, I fear that punishment will touch you, will overcome you from ar-rahman. Why? Because if you die upon shirk, you will be in the hellfire forever. فَتَكُونَ لِلشَّيْطَانِ وَلِيَّا. And you will be a companion of a shaitan in the hellfire. Yani you will be with the shaitan as well. قَالَ أَرَاغِبٌ أَنْتَ عَنْ آلِهَتِي يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ. So his father replied to him, do you reject my gods, O Ibrahim? Then he said to him, لَإِنْ لَمْ تَنْتَهِ لَأَرْجُمَنَّكَ وَهْجُرْنِي مَلِيَّا. If you don't stop this, calling me to leave off my idols, leave off the way of my forefathers, I will indeed stone you. So get away from me safely before I punish you. قَالَ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكَ. So even though his father rebuked him, look at how Ibrahim replied to him, عَلَيْهِ سَلَامُ السَّلَامُ. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكَ. Ibrahim said, peace be on you. سَأَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكَ رَبِّي. I will seek forgiveness of my Lord for you. And that is what we don't follow Ibrahim in, seeking forgiveness for the people of shirk. But we can call upon Allah for their guidance. That is allowed. Allah yahdihim. For those who have non-Muslim parents, Allah yahdihim. And you can, and you're supposed to be righteous to them, no doubt. وَإِنْ جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَنْ تُشْرِكَ بِمَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِعِلْمٍ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبُهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. If they call you to do shirk, to do evil, don't obey them in that, but be good companions to them in the dunya. Nah, be good companions to them, as Allah mentioned, Luqman. Then he continued, إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِي حَفِيًّا. He said, my Lord, I will ask forgiveness of my Lord for you. Verily he is to me ever most gracious. Then Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام continued, he said, وَأَعْتَزِلُكُمْ وَمَا تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَأَدْعُوا رَبِّي عَسَىٰ أَلَّا أَكُونَ بِدُعَاءِ رَبِّي شَقِيًّا. I shall turn away from you and from those whom you invoke besides Allah, and I shall call upon my Lord, and I hope that I shall not be unblessed in my invocation to my Lord. Na'am. So that was the call of Ibrahim alayhi salam to his father. And there were so many stories, so many benefits from that discourse, how Ibrahim alayhi salam was gentle with his father. And this should be for each and every one of us who has parents. We be gentle with them, we be kind with them. How is it your father, he used to pay the bills for you. He gave you shelter. He used to go out early in the morning to work for you, to educate you, to aid you, to clothe you, to feed you, all of that. And then you turn away when you get older. And then you think you have reached a level higher than your father. And you think you've reached a level where you can rebuke your father. A'udhu billah. This is a person who's so ungrateful. A person who doesn't have shukr. A person who is wretched, who is evil to his parents. A person is wretched, and he's a person who has not been blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he should answer them back, that he should belittle them, that he should look down upon them. You don't even sit in the place where they're supposed to sit, in the house. Even some of the salaf, when they would be afraid, if they ate with their parents, they would be afraid to eat a morsel that their parents were looking at. To that extent, they're afraid that they will eat something that their parents were looking at it, and so they took something that their parents desired. Yani from the halal. So look at that, ya ikhwan. Salaf were different. The Sahaba radiallahu anhu were different. They had honor and respect. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, how he had respect for his father. He knew the answer of the date palm tree. When the Prophet ﷺ said, which tree is like the believer? Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu knew the answer, but he didn't answer. Respect and honor for his father. He didn't want to speak, and he had shyness in that which is good. وَالْحَيَاءُ كُلُّهُ خَيْرٌ All of that is good. وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ And look how his manner was. And likewise you find many of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, if you look at their lives and how they were as young companions, they had respect. They had respect for their parents. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, he supplicated for his father to be guided, and he sought forgiveness for his father, and that was the mistake, that we do not seek forgiveness for the mushrikeen. So do not follow him in that. Na'am. And that actually, Shaykh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di rahimahullah said, the istighfar of Ibrahim for his father actually was because of a promise that he promised him with. So it was only actually to fulfill a promise. So he said what he said, na'am, but when he got clarified to him that he's not supposed to say that, he desisted. And he turned, he sought, يعني, tabarra'a min, he left it and he didn't continue seeking forgiveness for his father. And this is the way of the repentful one. This is the one who turns back to the truth. As soon as he knows the truth, he comes back. And Ibrahim a.s. was a great example for that. وَمِنْهَا أَنَّ اللَّهَ اتَّخَذَهُ خَلِيلًا Allah took Ibrahim as a khalil. And only two Allah took as a khalil. The Rasul ﷺ and Ibrahim. Khalil. وَالْخُلَّةُ أَعْلَى دَرَجَاتِ الْمَحَبَّةِ And that's the highest level of love. So not only did Allah love Ibrahim ﷺ and Rasulullah ﷺ, but they were considered to be khalilullah. They had that khulla, that higher level than the love. Allah showed them higher level than that, than just love. وَهَذِهِ الْمَرْتَبَةُ لَمْ تَحْصُلْ لِأَحَدٍ مِنَ الْخَلْقِ And this is not for anyone else except those two from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messengers. وَمِنْهَا And from the blessings that Allah blessed Ibrahim alayhi salam from, the blessings Allah blessed Ibrahim with, مَا أَكْرَمَهُ اللَّهُ بِهِ مِنَ الْكَرَامَاتِ الْمُتَنَوِّعَةِ جَعَلَ فِي ذُرِّيَّتِهِ النُّبُوَّةِ He blessed him that in his children, the two sons, came prophets. From Ismail came the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from that lineage. And from Ishaq, Ya'qub and Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. وَأَخْرَجَ مِنْ صَلْبِهِ أُمَّتَيْنِ Two nations that came out from his loins, from Bani Israel. And Allah chose him to build the Kaaba. And we mentioned that in the first two lessons. Allah chose him and his son Ismail to build the Kaaba. That house of Allah which is placed there, na'am, for the people to come from different parts of the world, from far and wide, to come to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is indeed praise for Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And from it, Allah raised him in knowledge and certainty and quwwatul al-hujjah and strong proof that he had in sufficing those he argued with. So for example, when he argued or when he disputed with his father, Azar, and the people, the mushrikun, he said to them, when he saw the moon, when he saw the stars, when he saw the sun, all of that set, he said, how are you going to worship? How can you worship those that set? How can you worship those that disappear? Those that cannot come to you and answer your call. Those that cannot help you and remove harm and bring about good. How can you call upon them? And he used those arguments against them. So Allah gave him that hujjah. وَتِلْكَ حُجَّتُنَا أَتَيْنَاهَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَى قَوْمِهِ نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتِ مَنْ نَشَاءِ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ حَكِيمٌ عَلِيمٌ That's the hujjah. وَتِلْكَ حُجَّةٌ Allah gave Ibrahim to his people. And that is the hujjah of clarifying the truth to suffice them that they cannot answer. That is the hujjah. And Shaykh al-Sa'di rahimahullah, in that verse he said that hujjah Allah gives it to the prophets and messengers, and likewise he gives it to the ulama. Allah raises them. نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتِ مَنْ نَشَاءِ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ حَكِيمٌ عَلِيمٌ Allah raises the prophets and messengers and those that follow them, the ulama, Allah raises them. Because Allah raises them with what? With dunya? No. Allah raises them with hujjah. the proof. Allah gives them the quwwah, quwwatul istidlal. And you see that with ulama. You see what Sheikh Rabi', for example, is writing in newspapers, answering the doubts of those who bring doubts, and Sheikh Salih Fawzan answering newspapers and clarifying to the people, to the general masses. And likewise, you see in their books, quwwatul hujjah, as if you are alive when you're reading them. Alive meaning your heart is alive, attentive, with the strong proofs that have been established, with the Quranic verses that have been explained, with the tafasir of the salaf. Wallahi, is as if you are alive. Yani, your heart is alive. And wallahi, when you read some of the others, besides the scholars, the innovators, as if you're reading something and your heart is dead. Yani, as if it's not for the living. This is not for the living. What will bring your life, your heart alive? What will bring your heart to be attentive? Is you turn back to the Quran and Sunnah. That is what will give you life. That is what will give you happiness. وَتِلْكَ حُجَّتُنَا أَتَيْنَاهَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتٍ مَنْ نَشَاءٍ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ حَكِيمٌ عَلِيمٌ. Read the books of the Salaf. Go read, for example, Tawheed. وَإِثْبَاتِ صِفَةِ الرَّبُّ ابْنُ خُزَيْمَةِ. All of it is قَالَ اللَّهُ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. You see, the Salaf, the people of the scholars of the past, they used to write little and concise and stick to the narrations. Nowadays, in the latter days, people talk much and don't stick to the narrations. They bring lots of opinions from themselves and they go astray and they lead others astray. Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah gave him the strength of ilm and yaqeen. He said, أَرِنِي كَيْفَ تُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى قَالَ أَوَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ. He said, show me how you give life to the dead. And Allah replied, do you not believe? قَالَ بَلَى. He said, rather I do. وَلَكِنْ لِيَطْمَئِنَّ قَلْبِي. So only so that my heart becomes content. My heart becomes more certain. قَالَ فَخُدْ أَرْبَعَةً مِنَ الطَّيْرِ. He said, take مِنَ الطَّيْرِ فَصُرْهُنَّ إِلَيْكَ ثُمَّ جَعَلْ عَلَى كُلِّ جَبَلٍ مِنْهُنَّ جُزْآءً. Take four of birds and put in every mountain, يعني, a part of them, a portion of them, or piece of them. ثُمَّ دْعُوهُنَّ يَأْتِينَكَ سَعْيًا. Then call them and they will come to you. They will come to you. وَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. They will come to you, يعني, being given life after they were without life. So Allah showed him how he gave life to the dead. Not because he didn't believe, but because he wanted to increase in his yaqeen. And Allah gave him that. And from the blessings, Allah blessed Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam with أَنَّ مَنْ عَزَمَ عَلَى فِعْلِ الطَّاعَاتُ وَبَدْلِ مَقْدُورِهِ فِي أَسْبَابِهَا ثُمَّ حَصَلَ مَانِعٌ يَمْنَعُ مِنْ إِكْمَالِهَا أَنَّ أَجْرَهُ قَدْ وَجَبَ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Ibrahim alayhi salam was called to sacrifice his son as a test. And even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after that dream was came true, that he was about to sacrifice his son, and Allah replaced that with the sheep. And this shows us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him for doing that which he called him to, even though in the end he replaced it with a sheep. Na'am. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't want Ibrahim alayhi salam to have any feeling of love more than him. For Ibrahim alayhi salam loved his son Ismail. And this shows us, do not love the dunya above Allah. Do not love your children above the deen. Do not love the children. You say, ma'alesh, ma'alesh. Doesn't matter, doesn't matter. Don't compromise in that which will cause destruction to yourself and your children. Don't compromise and bring about destruction. But rather, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek Him in all that you do. وَكَمَا ذَكَرَهُ اللَّهُ فِي قِصَةِ الذَّبْحِ. نعم, we mentioned that. وَمِنْهَا مَا فِي قَصَصِهِ مِنْ آدَابَ الْمُنَاظَرَةِ. نعم, from the blessings Allah gave him is in many of the disputes that he had, Allah blessed him in being good at arguing in ways that are better, such that he sufficed the one he's disputing with, or he sufficed the one who's calling to Islam. وَمِنْهَا أَنَّ مِنْ نِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْعَبْدِ هِبَةَ الْأَوْلَادَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And from that also, from the blessings Allah gave Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, and he gives also to those who Allah blesses, is that Allah Azza wa Jal blessed Ibrahim with the blessed progeny, with a blessed progeny and lineage to have two ummas, nations of prophets from his lineage. And this shows us not only the blessing that Allah gave him, but look at the shukr Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam had by praising Allah for that. Alhamdulillah alladhi wahaba li ala al-kibari Ismail wa Ishaq. Thanking Allah that has given him Ismail and Ishaq even at an old age. إلى آخر الدعاء. وقال جل ذكره في الثناء عموما على من يدعو الله بصلاح ذريته. And also Allah praise those who call upon Allah asking for a good progeny, asking for good children. حتى إذا بلغ أشده وبلغ 40 سنة. When a person reaches 40 years old, 40 years of age, and he has reached his strength, if you like, at that age. قال ربي أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي. This is what he says. Oh Lord, I thank you for your blessings that you have blessed me with. وعلى والدي نعم وأن أعمل صالحا. Upon myself and upon my parents, and you have blessed me to do good deeds. تَرْضَاهُ, that which you are pleased with. وَأَصْلِحْ لِي فِي ذُرِّيَّتِي. And, oh Allah, rectify my children. Rectify for me my children. إِنِّي تُبْتُ إِلَيْكَ وَإِنِّي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. I turn to you in repentance, and I am from the Muslims. Surah Al-Ahqaf, verse 15. This surah, or this verse, shows us again the dua that we say for our children in your sujood, in the best times. Allahumma ahdihim, Allahumma aslihum. And one of the mashayikh, he mentioned, Sheikh Suleiman, he mentioned that when you get angry at your kids, because sometimes they may do something that angers you, could be an accident, could be something, you know, don't say bad words to them. Rather, say Allah ahdik. Allah ahdik. May Allah guide you. Allah ahdihim, Allah aslihum, Allah aslih walak. Make a supplication that is a good supplication. And he mentions that even with regards when you're driving, and I know that's difficult sometimes when you're driving and you're frustrated, and you know, get used to saying Allah yahdik. Yes, some people they cut you up and they, you know, drive dangerously. Allah yahdihim. Okay, that's better than saying bad words. So it's for every one of us to guard their tongues in that situation. فإن العبد إذا مات انقطع عمله. So why we supplicate for our children? For their betterment. Because when you die, all of your actions cease, except for three: sadaqatun jariyah, aw ilmun yuntafa' bihi an-nas, or children, or knowledge that the people benefit from, or a pious child that supplicates for you. Idha mata ibnu adam inqata 'amaluhu illa min thalathin: sadaqatin jariyah, wa ilmin yuntafa' bihi an-nas, wa waladin salih. Walad here doesn't mean boy, means child that supplicates for you. So you're in your grave and you're getting reward because you left a pious child supplicating for you. You're in your grave and you left sadaqa jariya. You're in your grave, you left continuous charity, you left knowledge that's beneficial. You will be rewarded while you're in your grave. So look at the ulama. Sheikh Ali Nasir Faqih said, the ulama, they have all three. Pious child, not only their children, the ummah's children, all of them supplicate for him. Alim, look what he gets. Not only that, the knowledge they left behind. So much reward. And sadaqa jariya. How many good things they call the people to do. Build masjid. Build this. Build a well. Build a school. They call the people to do that. They get reward for calling the people to do good. And so they get all three. So that's why Allah raises them as well. Allah raises them many levels. He blesses them to be upon that level. ومنها أن المشاعر والمواضع الأنساك من جملة الحكم فيها أن فيها تذكيرات لمقامات الخليل. نعم. When we go for Hajj, we remember Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. Of course, we remember him when we go to and we do tawaf. Isn't it that we pray two rak'ahs after Maqam Ibrahim? Behind Maqam Ibrahim, right at the back. Pray behind Maqam Ibrahim. واتخذوا مقام إبراهيم مصلى. They take the Maqam Ibrahim as a place of for prayer. That means at the back, after the Ta'ifin wal Akifin. Then is Ruka'i Sujood, there at the end. So go to the back and pray your two rak'ahs. Again, signifying that Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, this is the house that he built. He alayhi salatu salam built. That we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa iman billahi wa rasulihi. Wa hatha ala liqtida'i bihim. Fi kulli ahwalihim al-diniyya. Wa kulli ahwal al-rusul al-diniyya. And likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encouraged that and commanded that وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمُ مُصَلَّى Surah Al-Baqarah verse 125. And from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised him to supplicate for that house and supplicate for Makkah وَطَحِرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ that to purify this house for who? For the ones doing tawaf. Whose supplication? Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam. The ta'ifin, wal-akifin, and those coming for i'tikaf, to reside for a certain period of time, to seclude themselves to worship Allah. Wa rukka'i sujood, and those who come to bow and to prostrate to Allah. And from that is, he said, fi buyutin adina Allahu an turfa'a wa yudhkara fiha smuh. In the house, or in the houses, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has permitted that his name is raised. Naam, his name is mentioned and is raised. And that is referring to the houses of Allah. And the house of Allah that Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam he built, no doubt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is extolled. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is exalted. Subhanahu wa ta'ala in that place. So look how great Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam is. Naam, anna afdal al-wasaya ala al-itlaq ma wassa bihi Ibrahimu banih. ويعقوب وهو الوصية بملازمة القيام بالدين والاجتماع على ذلك. And also from the greatest of advice is that which Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام advised his own son يعقوب نعم بنيه ويعقوب and يعقوب means so he advised his lineage, his progeny to be upon لا إله إلا الله. That is the وصية of Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. And look also, likewise, Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam is always mentioned in our salawatul khams, 5 times a day. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallayta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid. Wabarik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, every day we praise him and every day we remember him. Naam. Just as we send salah upon Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we send it just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised and raised Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam to a high level. Likewise, we send salah upon the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam gathered together khair dunya wa deen. Yani he supplicated for the good of this life and the good of the deen. وَرْزُقْهُمْ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَشْكُرُونَ Supplicating that Allah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them with provisions, with thamarat, with fruits, that they may be grateful. So we ask Allah for good in this life and good in the hereafter. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ Asking Allah for His blessings. And from the blessings that Allah blessed Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam is the legislation of salam, giving salam. Naam. The one who comes and he enters, he says, Salamu alaykum. And it is an obligation to reply that salam to the one who says salam to you. And also to be good to the guest, which we have mentioned earlier. And from it is targhib fi an yakuna ahl insan. وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّ شُؤُونَ بَيْتِهِ حَازِمِينَ مُسْتَعِدِّينَ لِكُلِّ مَا يُرَادُ مِنْهُمْ مِنَ الشُؤُونَ وَالْقِيَامِ مُهِمَّاتِ الْبَيْتِ Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام, he aided who? He aided his family. He was with Sarah, looked after Sarah. Naam, and when she was not able to continue to stay with Hajar, she didn't want Hajar, he took Hajar. Naam, he took her towards Mecca by the will of Allah. We don't know how. We don't know, but we accept that this is by the will of Allah. And he brought for her water, and he brought for her dates. He brought for her whatever he could find. as aid for his wife. And Allah willed that he left her there. He left her then. Allah willed that she went from Safa to Marwa 7 times looking for water thereafter. And Allah willed that she found water and it gushed forth, that Zamzam, until today we are drinking it and it is blessed. And you make dua when you read it, drink it. Zamzam lima shuriba lahu. Allah willed that Ibrahim alayhi salam, after many years, he came back and he saw his son Ismail. Allah willed that he aided him and chose for him a better spouse. Allah willed that he advised him with a better spouse. All of that is Muhimmat al-Bayt. Helping your house to be a good household. Helping your children to be upright. Don't leave them. Don't leave them to fend for themselves. Don't leave them without help. Don't leave them. Aid them. Grow up with them. And help them to that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Guiding them. وَمِنْهَا أَنَّ إِتْيَانَ وَاللَّهِ Especially in this country. If you leave them, they will go astray and then you regret it. Oh, my son has left me. Oh, my daughter has left me. Yes. Make them love the deen of Allah. Be with them. And even the Salaf, they used to play with their children. Play with them. Don't leave them. There was one of the scholars of the Salaf. He said, my daughter, and he wrote it down in a biography, that my daughter, she asked me one day, come and have tea. You know, they come and they bring the, it's not real tea, but you know, they come and they're making tea in. And he joined in with her. He joined in with her. It's not tea, but he joined in with her. Likewise, that's how we should play with our children. Join in with their games. Join in with that which they enjoy. Look at Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ya Aba Nughair, ma fa'al, Ya Aba Umair, ma fa'al al-Nughair. When he had the bird, and the bird died. This young boy had a bird and it died. And he said, Ya Aba Umair, ma fa'al al-Nughair? And the Prophet played with him. Oh Aba Umair, what happened to the little bird? But he said it in rhyme form to make the boy feel a bit softened and not to cry much. Ya Aba Umair, ma fa'al al-Nughair? He's playing with them. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he showed that. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would be prostrating and Hassan and Hussein radiallahu anhum, I would jump on his back. And he didn't come out from his sujood until they walked off, until they left. He stayed in his sujood. And they were playing on his back. And even to some extent, the scholars, they say, leave when the children come and they want to pray next to you. And they pray next to you. Even if they're naked, sometimes they come and they go, no underwear. Leave them. It's not wajib upon them. Don't rebuke them. Don't turn them away. Let them enjoy the salah. Let them partake with you. And they will come and they will move the finger next to you in the tashahud. Leave them. Don't shun them. Let them love the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because wallahi, I've seen that. You see it with the young children up to 7, 8, 9, 10 years old, mashallah. Raghba, desire to learn. Best time to teach them the Quran. Best time to teach them manners. Best time to bring them to build upon that love. And be their friend when they get to 15. Because that's when they start looking at friends. That's when you're not that important as before. That's when now they're looking for others. You be their friend. And be their companion. And be with them. Ibrahim alayhi salam, na'am, he continued to look after his family. And that is example for each and every one of us. Na'am. Then he says, وَمِنْهَا ثَنَاءَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ أَنَّهُ أَتَى رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. And this is the last part he mentions. From it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Ibrahim to come to Allah with a pure heart. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. On a day when no wealth, no any children will aid you, except for the person who comes to Allah with a pure heart. بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Surah Shu'ara, verse 89. If you can look at tafsir of Ibn Kathir. Surah Shu'ara, min fadlik, afan, ma'alish. That's tafsir Ibn Kathir. Awla al-Sa'di. Sa'di, hatta ana shuf hada. So, Surah Shu'ara, verse 89. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ
بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ.
That is what's going to help you. You come to Allah with a pure heart. Su'ara, verse 89. Here, Shaykh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di, rahimahullah, he says about this blessed first verse, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ فَهَذَا الَّذِي يَنْفَعُهُ عِنْدَكَ. This is what will benefit you, that you come to Allah with a pure heart. وَهَذَا الَّذِي يَنْجُو مِنَ الْعِقَابِ. This is the one that will save you from punishment. وَيَسْتَحِقُّ جَزِيلَ الثَّوَابِ. And this is the one who deserves great reward. You come to Allah with a pure heart. وَالْقَلْبُ السَّلِيمِ مَعْنَاهُ الَّذِي سَلِيمَ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ. First thing is, it's free from shirk. That's a heart that is pure. Free from shirk. وَالشَّكِّ. And free from doubt. This is the haqq, yaqi. This is the truth. If the Quran was revealed on a mountain, it would crumble. This is the haqq. This is Islam. This is the tawheed and sunnah. There's nothing better than that. There's nothing that can make you happier than this deen. Eh wallah. وَمَحَبَّةِ الشَّرْ. He says, أَلَّذِي سَلِمَ مِنْ مَحَبَّةِ الشَّرْ. Free from loving evil things. مَحَبَّةِ الشَّرْ. He says, أَلَّذِي سَلِمَ مِنْ مَحَبَّةِ الشَّرْ. Free from loving evil things. Yes, لا يستوي الخبيث والطيب ولو أعجبك كثرة الخبيث. Even though the many things people like, they're not equal with the good things. They may like evil things. Many people may like evil, but it's not equal with the good. The good is better. So your heart is salim, free from shar, from loving shar, from loving evil. والإصرار على البدعة والذنوب. And to be persistent upon innovations and sins, free from that. That's why Shaykh Ubayd Hafidullah, he said about the when it was said to the Sufis that they are a people who when the brother, what's his name, Layhdi, that in the, what's his name, Yasir Qadi, he said, oh, they have, I feel in the presence of Sufis, he said, I feel so much love in their presence, so much brotherhood. Shaykh Ubayd said, they do not have piety. Sufis do not have piety. Because piety comes from what? From knowledge. And the book of Allah. From the book of Allah. And from the sunnah of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. How can you claim piety and your heart is crooked? Your heart is upon bid'ah. Your heart is upon shirk. Your heart contains doubts. Your heart contains that which Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala doesn't love. How can you claim piety? And how can you claim true brotherhood? This is not the case with Ahl Sunnah. Ahl Sunnah, truly they come to Allah with a pure heart. Those who come to Allah free from shirk, free from bid'ah, free from loving evil, free from being persistent upon bid'ah and sins. وَيَلْزَمُ مِنْ سَلَامَتِهِ مِمَّا ذُكِرَ اتِّصَافُهُ بِأَضَّادِهَا مِنَ الْإِخْلَاصِ. And also the opposite must be there of that which we mentioned. That is having ikhlas, and having ilm, and having yaqeen, certainty, and having mahabba for doing good, وَتَزْيِينُهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ, and beautifying it in your heart, وَأَن تَكُونَ إِرَادَتُهُ وَمَحَبَّتُهُ تَابِعَةً لِمَحَبَّةِ اللَّهِ, and that you're wanting to do something, whatever you desire, and you want to do something, should be in accordance with the love of Allah. وَهَوَاهُ تَبَعًا لِمَا جَاءَ عَنِ اللَّهِ, and your desire should be following that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. That's what your desire should be. Not in that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes. That was what Shaykh Abdul Rahman al-Sa'di rahimahullah said about those who come to Allah with إِجَّاءَ رَبَهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ, which is Surah Shu'ara, verse 89. And Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, when he came to this verse, إِجَّاءَ رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ, he said, سَلِيم أي سَالِم مِنَ الدَّنَسِ وَالشِّرْكِ, free from impurities and shirk. قال ابن سيرين, القلب السليم أن يعلم أن الله حق. ابن سيرين, محمد ابن سيرين, from the تابعين, he said that قلب سليم is a heart that knows the truth. أن يعلم أن الله حق, he knows that Allah is the truth. وأن الساعة آتية لا ريب فيها,
and he knows that the hour is coming, no doubt in that. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْعَثُ مَنْ فِي الْقُبُورِ, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise those that are in their graves. Allah will raise them. وَقَالَ السَّعِيدُ بْنُ مُسَيِّبُ الْقَلْبُ السَّلِيمُ هُوَ الْقَلْبُ الصَّحِيحُ. He said, that is a qalb salim. Pure heart is a true heart. A true heart. وَهُوَ قَلْبُ الْمُؤْمِنِ, that's the believer's heart. لِأَنَّ قَلْبَ الْكَافِرِ وَالْمُنَافِقِ مَرِيدٌ, because the heart of a disbeliever and a hypocrite is sick. So therefore, a qalbu salim is sahih, meaning it is upon well-being. It is upon goodness. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ, in their hearts is a disease. فَزَادَهُمَ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا, and Allah increased their disease, the hypocrites. قَالَ أَبُو عُثْمَانَ النَّيْسَابُورِ هُوَ الْقَلْبُ السَّالِمِ مِنَ الْبِدْعَةِ الْمُطْمَئِنُ إِلَى السُّنَّةِ, the heart which is free from innovations, that which is content to be upon the sunnah. Wallahi, always with Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, always, and with Shaykh Sa'di rahimahullah, always you see manhaj, methodology. Qalb salim, they bring you methodology, free from bid'ah and upon sunnah. That's qalb salim. So how could somebody come, tablighi, sufi, ikhwani, and say to you qalb salim, and he's crying all night, crying all... There's no qalb salim. If he's upon bid'ah, if he's upon hawa, his desires and innovation, that's not qalb salim. جَاءَ رَبُهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ, upon haqq, with ilm, with yaqeen, with amal, upon sunnah, upon tawheed. Qalb salim. This Tahir Qadri, people coming, walking, crying and crawling to him and kissing his hands. And qalb salim, this is crooked individual. How's qalb salim? Qalb salim, and they're giving money on the side to that Sufi one on YouTube. They're giving him money, queuing up to give him money, kissing his hand, giving money. Qalb salim? How's qalb salim? You should forbid the people from doing this. The Prophet would not allow people to do that. Rather, the Prophet said, whoever praises you should like throw dust on his face. That's the reality of somebody who starts praising you because he's helping shaitan against you. But no, these guys are like, yeah, alhamdulillah, maybe I have got it. Maybe I am it. Maybe I am the one, the chosen one. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so they keep their head above water with the money coming in. That's a qalb that is crooked. A qalb that is upside down, maqloob. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, إِذْ جَاءَ رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ, upon sunnah, away from shirk. Then Shaykh al-Sa'di rahimahullah added and finally finished by saying, أَنَّهُ سَلِيمٌ مِنَ الشُّرُورِ كُلِّهَا وَمِنْ أَسْبَابِهَا, free from evil and its reasons that lead to that. مَلْآنٌ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ وَالْبِرِّ وَالْكَرَمِ, full of goodness and full of righteousness and full of generosity. سَلِيمٌ مِنَ الشُّبُهَاتِ, free from doubts, al-qadiha, that are blameworthy. فِي الْعِلْمِ وَالْيَقِينِ, in knowledge and in certainty. وَمِنَ الشَّهْوَاتِ الْحَائِلَةِ بين العبد وبين كماله, and free from desires that come between the person and being and his completeness, to be upon goodness. سليم من الكبر ومن الرياء والشقاق والنفاق وسوء الأخلاق, free from arrogance, free from showing off, free from deviation, free from hypocrisy, free from evil manners. سليم من الغل والحقد, free from deviation and يعني حقد, free from الحقد, jealousy. ملآن بالتوحيد, full of توحيد والإيمان والتواضع and humility and إيمان and faith. تواضع للحق, accepting the truth with humility, humbling oneself to accept that. وللخلق, humbling oneself to the creation as well, not feeling arrogant above the people. واخفض جناحك للمؤمنين, and lower your wings to the believers. Where are you going, أخي? Where are you going? Up there? Did you reach the mountain in height? Did you penetrate the earth? You didn't do that. For why are you being arrogant for? Did you reach the mountains in height? As Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Isra. Huh? وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَخْرِقَ الْأَرْضِ وَلَنْ تَبْلُغَ الْجِبَالَ طُولًا. So why are you being arrogant for? وَالنَّصِيحَةَ للمسلمين, and giving advice to Muslims, والرغبة في عبودية الله, and enjoy, loving desiring to worship Allah, this is a qalb salim. وَفِي نَفْعِ عِبَادِ اللَّهِ, and in bringing about good, benefiting the servants of Allah. نعم. And that is a qalb salim. And that is someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala نعم secures, and He gives protection. سَلَامٌ عَلَى نُوحٍ فِي الْعَالَمِينَ سَلَامٌ عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمٍ إِنَّ كَذَلِكَ نَجَزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. All of those verses showing you that Allah rewards the righteous and He protects them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who learn and follow the example and guidance of Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam. Make us learn and how he was well-mannered towards his father, how he discussed with his father in ways that are beautiful, and that we become dutiful to our parents. May Allah forgive us our shortcomings towards them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us thankful towards our parents and how we address them and how we conduct ourselves with them. Oh Allah, forgive us, for indeed we have wronged ourselves. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. Oh Allah, forgive us and those who have preceded us in faith, and do not make hatred in our hearts for any of the believers who have preceded us. Indeed, you are رؤوف الرحيم, most kind and the most merciful. May Allah forgive us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.